हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज राशि राजदान फ्रॉम एल्गोजी। अगर आप लोगों को मेरी आवाज़ सुनाई दे रही है तो आप चैट बॉक्स में यस लिख दीजिए ताकि हम आगे बढ़ सकें। Thank you so much. So let's start with today's webinar. आज के वेबिनार में हम बात करेंगे डिस्कवरिंग ऑफ ग्रेट स्ट्रैटेजी फॉर इंडियन मार्केट। तो अभी तक हमने हमारी जो वेबिनार सीरीज जो हम कवर कर रहे हैं उसमें हमने सबसे पहले वेबिनार में बात की थी व्हाट एंड व्हाई ऑफ सिस्टम ट्रेडिंग की। उसके बाद हमने फ्री टूल्स फॉर सिस्टम ट्रेडिंग की बात की थी। देन लास्ट वेबिनार में एक मार्केट में जो 5 मोस्ट फेमस चार्टिंग प्लेटफॉर्म्स अवेलेबल हैं उनका हमने कंपैरिजन किया था। और आज हम कुछ स्ट्रैटेजीज के बारे में बात करेंगे जो कि आपके लिए फीजिबल रहेगी या आप जिनसे एल्गो ट्रेडिंग स्टार्ट कर सकते हैं। चलिए आगे बढ़ते हैं। सबसे पहले रिक्वायरमेंट जो एल्गो ट्रेडिंग के लिए होती है वो होती है ट्रेड प्लान की, क्योंकि अगर आप सिस्टम से ट्रेड करना चाहते हैं, आप सिस्टम ट्रेडिंग करना चाहते हैं तो आपको ट्रेड प्लान की जरूरत है, क्योंकि आपको रूल्स के साथ ट्रेड करना है। अब आपके जो रूल्स हैं वो आपको इस तरीके से रिप्रेजेंट करने हैं, आपको अपने रूल्स इस तरीके से लिखने हैं। ये ट्रेड प्लान का एक टेम्पलेट है जो मैंने यहाँ पे बना रखा है। आप देख सकते हैं यहाँ पे ट्रेडिंग स्टाइल से लेके ट्रेड टाइमिंग, माई ट्रेडिंग कैपिटल, ट्रेडिंग गोल्स, प्री मार्केट रूटीन, एंट्री क्राइटेरिया, एग्जिट क्राइटेरिया, रिस्क कैपेसिटी से लेकर हर चीज इस ट्रेड प्लान में मेंशन है। उसके साथ साथ एग्जीक्यूशन प्लान, ऑर्डर मैनेजमेंट मुझे क्या रखना है या एग्जीक्यूट किस तरीके से करना है अपनी स्ट्रैटेजी को, उसके बाद मेरी रिस्क कैपेसिटी क्या है, ये बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट होता है आपको अपना रिस्क डिफाइन करके रखना। और लास्ट है इवैल्यूएटेड एक्शंस। अब आपके पास एक फ्रेमवर्क भी होगा, अगर आपके पास एक ट्रेड प्लान है तो आपके पास एक फ्रेमवर्क भी है जिसके जिसके थ्रू आप कंपेयर कर सकते हैं अपनी परफॉर्मेंस को। आप क्योंकि आप रूल्स के साथ ट्रेड कर रहे हैं तो आप अपने एक्शंस को एक सिस्टमैटिक वे में इवैल्यूएट भी कर पाएंगे। तो इसी तरीके का एक ट्रेड प्लान आपको भी बनाना है। रिसर्च करिए, अपनी स्ट्रैटेजी को टेस्ट करिए, अपनी रिस्क कैपेसिटी को डिफाइन करिए, ऑर्डर मैनेजमेंट के तरीके का आपको यूज करना है अपनी स्ट्रैटेजी के लिए। हम उसके बारे में भी हम थोड़ा आगे चल के बात करेंगे कि किस तरह के स्ट्रैटेजी में किस तरह का ऑर्डर टाइप सूट करता है या प्रेफर कर सकते हैं। तो इस तरीके का एक ट्रेड प्लान सिस्टम बेस्ड ट्रेडिंग के लिए ट्रेडर्स को बनाना चाहिए ताकि वो अपने रूल्स पे स्टिक कर पाए और So you have to prepare a trade plan like such, in which you have to mention all of these things, and you can add more things as per your requirement. So let's move on, and I hope you, if you have seen the previous webinar, if you had joined us in the previous webinar, You must be familiar with this slide. So, what are we talking about exactly here? First, these are the major components of system-based trading. First is buy and sell logic, then risk management, order and slippage management, and position management. So, the foundation of any trade is a good buy and sell logic. And where does it come from? It comes from strategies. A good buy and sell logic comes from strategies, or whichever buy and sell logic you use. So and that buy and sell logic, if combined with risk management and order or slippage management and position management, if you combine all these components together, you will be able to minimize your risk, and you can do profitable trading, because your risk is managed, your orders are managed, your position is managed, and this is what is required for a system-based trading. And again, let's talk about whole is greater than sum of parts. Again, if we see all the things together, it is always better than we see them in pieces. So this was all about components of system-based trading. Now, coming to free strategy resources. So what are the free strategy resources that we have? To talk about this, I'll give you a recap of our previous webinar, where we did a tool comparison of the five most famous charting platforms available in the market. So this was my personal research on in which I talked to different stakeholders of the market, and I've set up features on the basis of priority. For example, these features have been prioritized, but this is a generic view of market. So it doesn't mean that if I have written build custom UI here as fourth priority, it could be number one priority for someone else. So this is just general view, and let's see. Let's take a recap of this. So the first point that I mentioned here was free strategies collection. So here in TradingView, 100,000 plus strategies are available for free. In Excel, there are negligible. In MetaTrader 4, around 10,000. In AmiBroker, around 10,000. And in Python, around 3,000. So you can see here, since a large number of strategies are present in TradingView, so today we'll be covering the strategies present in TradingView and how to get started with them for algo trading. We'll be covering the strategies in MT4 and Excel and AmiBroker in the coming webinars. So this is part one of discovering great strategies for the Indian market series. And then here, if you are looking for free live data, then TradingView and Excel are good sources. Similarly, if we look at the speed to ideate and deploy algos, then TradingView is here 10. I've given on a scale of 1 to 10, I've given 10 to TradingView, because it is very hands-on. The user interface is very friendly here. We talked about this whole slide. We talked about the whole tool comparison in the previous webinar. You can refer to the recording of the previous webinar for this. Now let's come back to the slide. And so today we'll be covering three strategies of TradingView. So first of all, we have to talk about the strategy selection criteria. So what should be the strategy selection criteria? Let's talk about it here. Again, here I have created this table for easy representation, so that you all can see and I can explain it better. So here features are given for strategy selection, and then they are set up on the basis of priority. Now the first and the foremost priority for a strategy is that it should be profitable. So profitable is summum bonum of all the desirable features. And if a strategy is not profitable, you won't go ahead with it. It doesn't matter if it fits other parameters or features that you're looking for. But if it is not profitable, then why would you go for a strategy? So this is the number one thing that traders look for in a strategy and should look for in a strategy. It should be profitable. देन द नेक्स्ट इज कैन स्टार्ट ट्रेडिंग विद लो मार्जिन. नाउ सपोज यू हैव 2 lakhs इन अकाउंट एंड यू हैव कम अक्रॉस अ न्यू ग्रेट स्ट्रैटेजी एंड यू वांट टू टेस्ट इट एंड यू हैव जस्ट 2 lakhs इन अकाउंट बट इट इज नॉट एडवाइजेबल टू पुट ऑल ऑफ योर मार्जिन इन अ न्यू स्ट्रैटेजी. To test it, you should be putting a part of it. So, for example, if you put 50k in testing, it would be better than employing all the complete 2 lakhs, the complete capital in that strategy. So, new strategies require initial run in testing mode, and to test your strategy, you can test them in NSE cash or options, buying, bracket order, cover order. So here you can see I mentioned, I've mentioned the margin requirement for trading in Bank Nifty Future Intraday in Alice Blue, that is Antwerp. It is 13,090 and for bracket order, it is just 6,456. You can get started, you can test your strategy in this much margin. So you should be able to test your strategy. You can you should be able to get started with your strategy with a low margin. It is not advisable to employ complete capital. Now the next feature is without overnight risk. So suppose you're trading in Nifty Future. And if you don't want to go with the overnight risk, it is advisable. It is advisable that you hedge your position. What it will do is, if you hedge your position, it will reduce your gap up or gap down risk. For example, you are long in Nifty Future and you want to carry the strategy. If you are a positional trader and you want to carry the strategy, then what you will do is you will buy a put along, and even if the next day market opens in gap down, since your position is hedged, it will reduce your risk. There could be loss, but it will not be as much as it would be without if you were not hedging your position. And again, if you are trading intraday, then there is no overnight risk. So either you are trading intraday, or if you are going for positional trades, then hedging is preferable. So look for a strategy that in which you can easily do, in which you can easily hedge, or if you are intraday trader, then you should prefer an intraday strategy. And the next is next feature is fit your personality as a trader. Now, it is psychological. It is psychological that if you are an intraday trader, you would not go for positional. It is against your personality. You have built up your personality as a as an intraday trader, and you won't be comfortable. You won't be comfortable in going against your rules, or you won't be comfortable in carrying your position because of the risk associated with it. So, and similarly, if you are a positional trader, you might not. You might not be comfortable in squaring off your position in intraday. So you should look for a strategy that fits your personality as a trader. You shouldn't be going against your personality, because suppose if you have written if you have a straight plan. I'm revising it again. Here you can see in the trading style. The first point that I've mentioned here is either you are an intraday swing positional or any other if available kind of trader. So if you will be going against your rules, then it is not system trading. You have to stick to your rules. So if you are an intraday trader, look for intraday strategies. If you are a positional trader, then do not go for intraday strategy. Also, there should be good number of input parameters in a strategy so that you can adjust the strategy as per your requirement. Now the next feature is work at least in 2 or 3 phases of the market. So there are 3 phases of the market: bear, bull, and consolidation phase. इफ अ स्ट्रैटेजी इज वर्किंग गुड इन आइदर ऑफ द इन 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 एटलीस्ट टू ऑफ द थ्री फेजेस ऑफ मार्केट देन यू कैन गो फॉर इट. देन कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट should be easy to execute. Yes, a strategy should be easy to execute. Why? For example, if there are too many or too less signals in a strategy. Let's take an example of Nifty. Let's just take an example of Nifty. So an average intraday move in Nifty would be around 100 points. So if according to your strategy, you are keeping the target at 130, or you are keeping too small profit. If your strategy is giving you too large profit, that is 130, or it is giving you too small profit, for example, 15 points, 10 points. So it is not advisable to go for that strategy because it is not practical. If the average move of Nifty is around 100, and you would just keep waiting for that large profit and it might not come. You might not be able to book your profit. So a strategy shouldn't capture too large profit, and too small profit is also not as advisable because most of your profit will go into your trading cost. And if there are too less signals, then it will get you frustrated that the strategy is not working, it is not giving me any signals. And if there are too many signals, then it will also increase your trading cost. Moreover, it will create a chaos. So there shouldn't be too many or too less signals in a strategy. Now the next feature is should not have too much slippage compared to profit. So some strategies may lose as much as 50% profit on chart to slippage cost in execution. So if your most of your profit is going into slippage, the money that you could have earned is going into slippage, then that strategy is not advisable. If you are not trading for pennies, you shouldn't go for it. Now, let's come to the second priority features that I have mentioned here. Which is backtesting matrix. So backtesting means to test out something in historical data. And why it is important? It is important for development. It is important for the development and optimization of a strategy. So trades that would have occurred in the past using the rules of the strategy that we are testing. So if we are backtesting, what we see on chart is, we see the trades that would have happened in the past using the rules or the strategy that we are testing. And if you are backtesting, you can optimize and improve your strategy, and you can also gain confidence to go for a trial run. If you are going for a trial run in live market, you should have at least backtested your strategy first, because it gives you confidence and you could have optimized or improved your strategy on the basis of that. You can if the backtested results are good enough, you can just finally apply them in the real time market. And we'll be talking about backtesting in detail in the coming webinar. We'll cover performance metrics and performance metrics like win-loss ratio, payoff profitability, payoff probability, and Sharpe ratio, etc. in the coming webinar. That is the second part of this series. Now, the next feature is, should have CAR and MDD minimum C. Now, what is CAR and MDD? Let's understand it with an example. So CAR is compound annual return, and MDD is maximum drawdown. So if we talk about it in easier terms, so it simply means that how much money you are making per unit of risk. Now, for example, here you can see here CAR by MDD is given 3.54. So it means that for 3.54 sorry. So here it means how much money you are making per unit. For example, here you are making here 3.54 for every one unit of risk. You are making 3.54 profit for every one unit of risk. Now it is said that higher the CAR by MDD, the better the strategy is. Now let's understand it with an example. So here you can see I've drawn this table here. Here we have initial capital in all the cases as 1 lakh. And ending capital after 12 months, it is different for all the cases. Here it is 1,50,000. Here it is 1,35,000, then 1,30,000, and 1,23,000. And cumulative average return, if we calculate here, is 50,000, 35,000, and 30,000, 23,000. And MDD. MDD is assumed to be, here MDD was 30,000, here MDD was 15,000, and here 9,500 and 6,500. Now we calculate this ratio. The ratio for first case is 1.67 and then 2.33, 3.16, 3.54. What we can observe from here is, you can see cumulative average return here is 50,000, which is the maximum in this table. But the CAR and MDD by MDD is 1.67. And in the opposite case, where the CAR is the least, the minimum amount, which is 23,000, the CAR by MDD is here is 3.54. So which strategy would you prefer? If you are comfortable in, if you are not comfortable in long drawdowns, then you shouldn't go for strategies with a large max, a large MDD. And here, the CAR by MDD is 3.54. So higher the CAR by MDD, the better the strategy. So you can go for this strategy. Money making depends on CAR MDD of strategy or account margin and risk capacity. So if you are comfortable in a long drawdown, if you are not comfortable in giving 30,000 in as a drawdown, because you saw this drawdown, if you are not comfortable with this drawdown, you shouldn't go for such a strategy which gives you long drawdowns. Now coming back to the table, here is our last feature, which is win loss ratio should be acceptable. Now how can we define win loss ratio? Let's understand it with an example again. Win loss ratio. So win loss ratio is average money made in winning trades upon average money lost in losing trades. So this is a win loss ratio, and let's understand it with the help of this graph. You can see here we have given win percentage here, and here we have win loss ratio. So here is the break even line, and you can see here the win percentage is 20%. Win percentage is 20%, and win loss ratio must be around 5. So, and in this case, when win loss ratio is 70%, sorry, when win percentage is 70%, win loss ratio must be around 0.34 or 5, 0.44 or 5, 0.5 around. So what we understand from this example is that if average money made in a winning trade is large, if average money, for example, here the average money made in this example where the win percentage is 20%. So here the average money made in winning trade is large. That is why the win loss ratio is more here. So it is large, but this does not guarantee that the number of winners are more. It does not guarantee that the number of winners are more, because they are just, the win loss ratio is quite high here, but the win percentage is just 20%. And similarly, if the win percentage is high, it doesn't guarantee that win loss ratio is more, because here the average money lost in losing trades could be more. इवन इफ द नंबर ऑफ लूजिंग ट्रेड्स वाज लेस बट द एवरेज मनी लॉस इन लूजिंग ट्रेड्स वर मोर हियर सो द विन लॉस रेशियो शुड बी एक्सेप्टेबल इट शुडन्ट बी जस्ट टू हाई और टू लेस बिकॉज इफ इट इज टू हाई इट कुड बी अ पॉसिबिलिटी दैट द विन परसेंटेज इज वेरी लेस एंड इफ इट इज टू इफ द विन लॉस रेशियो इज टू लेस देन देयर कुड बी अ केस देन विन परसेंटेज इज वेरी हाई सो द विन लॉस रेशियो इट शुड बी एक्सेप्टेबल Now let's come back to the slide. So here again, we have this system here with A with the win-loss ratio 3/10, and here the win-loss ratio is 3/10, and it is making more money than system B, where the win-loss ratio is 8/10. But here you can see the win-loss ratio is 3/10. So even if it is making more money than system B, would you be comfortable in deploying system A? The answer. Is up to you, and it should be no. So here I have added a small note for in talking about VO advantage. So if you to start trading with low margin or to test your strategy or go for an initial test run before deploying your full capital, you can go for bracket order. So bracket order. Provides more robust execution than usual intraday orders because you don't have to worry about the position because the stop loss and target you have already given at the time when entry was created. So even if your internet breaks down or your charting platform crashes, you are safe. Your trade will be safe because the stop loss and target are already in the exchange. So VO has its very good advantages. And here you can see the margin required for Bank Nifty future is just 6456, 6546, which is good to go. Now, let's come to the next slide, and we'll finally be talking about strategies. The strategies that we have chosen from the trading view. So these strategies here, these strategies that are given here are Super Trend by Kivank, Ozzy Bilger, Bollinger Bands, Pivot Extension, Channel Breakout Strategy, RSI Strategy, MACD. So these are very common strategies and you can get started with them. For algo trading, you can test them or you can learn algo trading. If you are new to algo trading, you can just go and deploy them in your chart and see how the whole system works. The course for these strategies are already provided in the help manual. I will show you where. So these strategies here are not our recommendation. These are just for the educational purpose. And these may not be the best strategies available, but these are good enough to get you started with TradingView. You can understand them very easily. They are hands-on and you will be able to understand them and you can get started with algo trading very smoothly if you test these strategies. I'll show you where you can find the code for these strategies and you will also find the instructions with them as in how you can deploy these strategies on your chart. Now here also we have different we have defined these strategies on these features. So first is minimum margin required. Yes, all of these strategies can be started with minimum margin. Again, margin requirement is mentioned here, so you can test out these strategies or you can get started with minimum margin. Overnight risk, does these strategies carry overnight risk? All of these are manageable and easy to execute. Yes, all of these are easy to execute. So we have these two more strategies here which is RSI system trading with bracket order and NSE option trading strategy. So I'll be showing you, I'll be deploying this strategy in live market. I've already put them on the chart. I'll be showing you in some time. So this is a bracket order strategy in which you will be sending stop loss and target along with the entry order. And here it is an option strategy. This one is an option strategy. So I'll show you how to deploy this, how you can get started with the NSE option strategy as well. Then next is backtesting matrix. Yes, it is available in all of them, but for just the two of these, only simulation is available. You have to test the strategy. You can press the strategy in paper trading mode. Then time frame, 15 minutes or less, 15 minutes or less, 15 minutes or less. So all of these strategy are intraday strategy. And if you want to go for positional trading, you can adjust the input parameters according to that. Now here you can see as mentioned strategy type. It is here for a purpose because I'll be talking about on how you can use, how you can categorize your strategies, how you can categorize your strategies in this strategy type, and what order type should be preferred for that particular strategy. So for example, Super Trend by Kivang Rosie Bilgin, it is a strategy which is trend without predefined price. Similarly, Bollinger Band is a mean reversion strategy without predefined price. And pivot extension, mean reversion, channel breakout strategy, momentum, RSI strategy, mean reversion, MACD strategies, again, trend, Renko trend, price channel, momentum without predefined price. And these are also momentum strategies. Now, the average number of trades in intraday. You can see all of these strategies. In all of these strategies, the average number of trades are quite good. It is not too high or too less. So you can get started with this in intraday. Intraday or overnight. So how you should prefer these strategies. Super trend intraday, Bollinger Band intraday, and channel breakout strategy. You can go for both overnight or intraday. Then again, RSI strategy, intraday. Renko, you can go for both. Price channel strategy, you can go for both. And RSI trading system with bracket order, because it is bracket order. In bracket order, you can do only in intraday. So intraday and NSE option again in intraday. Now the input parameters for all these strategies. So you can see here, you can adjust these input parameters in these strategies. Quite good number of input parameters are present here. So you can, for example, in Supertrend, you can adjust ATR and ATR multiplier. In the NSE option strategy, you can see here, length, oversold, overbought, symbol, expiry. You can adjust so many parameters here according to your requirement. And RSI trading system, again, length, overbought, oversold. So all these input parameters you can adjust. Now let's come to this where these strategies are. So if you're looking for these strategies, you can find them here. So this is the help manual, mycoder.pro help, and how you can find this, where you can find this help manual. You just open your API bridge, go to the help button. When you click on the help button, it will redirect you to this page, and you'll be able to find this help manual here. Then after that, since we are looking for TradingView strategy, so we'll click on TradingView connection here. When you click on TradingView connection, you'll click on FAQs on TradingView algo trading. So here you can see the frequently asked questions have been answered here. So if you also have some questions, you can go through this manual. And here, another frequently asked question that people ask us is, can you give some good strategies with PineScript code? Because you need PineScript coding if you want to set automation. So here, all of these strategies present here already have PineScript codes. we have written Pine Script codes for these strategies, and you can set up automation in them with them, and you can try them out in paper trading mode, or with free version of TradingView as well. So I guess something wrong happened with the chart. So let's come back to the slide. So first we'll see RSI trading system with bracket order. I'm refreshing this chart and let's see what's the issue here. Okay. So you can see this is the bracket order strategy that we have. You can find it here in this manual, bracket order using chart based stop loss and target. And this will open up, the link will open up into this manual. So all the rules related to the strategy are given here. So this bracket order strategy is based on RSI. So as per the strategy, when RSI goes above the upper bound that you have mentioned, for example, I mentioned 70 here. So when RSI goes above 70, my long entry is created, and the stop loss and target that I have given with them, the order is sent for them as well. The signal is sent for them as well. And when RSI crosses 30, my short entry is created. Now, how can you put the Pine Script code for this strategy? In this help manual, you can see this TradingView settings here. Download the strategy file here. So when you find the strategy, you can click on this, copy this code and paste it in the Pine Editor section here, and then you can click on save and add it to the chart. When you add it to the chart, the strategy will get placed on the chart like this, and this RSI system will appear. Now you have to optimize the strategy. You have to change the input parameters according to your requirement. So here, what I've done is I wanted to show you a quicker signal generation, because I'm showing you a demo, and I'm showing you a demo. So I wanted signals to generate quickly. So I changed my parameters accordingly so that we can get some quick signals. So the default length of RSI is 14. So you can let it be, or you can change it according to your requirement. So I changed it to 4 so that I can show you how the strategy works. Now enter upper band or lower band. So you have to, it could be either 80, 40 or 70, 30, whatever you prefer. Then you can use reversal from upper bound, use reversal from lower bound. So if you tick on these, you will get reversal trades as well. For example, when RSI will cross 70, a short entry will be generated, and if it will cross 30, a long entry will be generated. Now it is important for you to put target points and stop loss points here. So I have written here 2.5 and 1, and you have to mention the quantity as well. So for example, if you are trading in Nifty, you will put 75 here. After you have changed the parameters according to your requirement, what you have to do is you have to check if the symbol that you have put here, the symbol here and symbol here should be the same. Then you place all the settings according to your requirement. For example, the market order that I've selected is market, and trading, since trading quantity, you can select the trading quantity, and whatever trading quantity you will mention here, the order will be placed in that only. Then you have to select. This is important and this is a must. If because the strategy is a bracket order strategy, you have to choose a product type as BO. Only then your stop loss and target will go along with the entry order. Then you have to save the configuration from here. And then what you have to do is you can come back to this manual. You'll come back to this manual and it is saying here that you have to set up the alert for automation. So this is the code that you have to copy. After copying this code, you have to click here, go to add alert and change the default code here. So when you change the default code here, copy and paste that particular code. Like, for example, like this, and click on create. So I had already created this alert here. I had already created an alert, and I'm using free version of TradingView. So just one alert can be created at a time. So now the alert is created and it is active. So whenever a signal will be whenever my requirement will be met, for example, whenever you can see here, when as RSI crossed 30, I got a short signal and quantity and SLR given here. So similarly, you can go back to the chart and you can see if the signals are working fine. So this is, you can find all the instructions about the strategy here, and you have to optimize it using the input. You can change the input parameters according to your requirement. So this is how this bracket order strategy will work. Now coming to the RSI, now this was all with RSI trading system with bracket order. Now let's come to NSE options algo trading for TradingView. So a lot of people ask us about option strategy. So if you want to see how the option strategy works in TradingView, especially with the Pine Strip, I'll show you how it works. So I have already set up the strategy in cloud. This is the cloud that I'm using. So here you can see. So before going to the chart, let me explain how this strategy will work for you. So this is NSE option strategy for TradingView. Again, we have used RSI indicator here for signal generation. And the strategy, according to the strategy rules, what happens is, I'll explain it here. First, you have to find the strategy, and where you can find the strategy, I'm going back to the cloud. And to find the strategy, we have put the strategy in public library. You can go to indicators, type NSE options algo strategy for TradingView. You can find the strategy here, click on it, and you can apply it on the chart, and it will be something like this. Now what I have done is, you can see too many here is a clutter of signals. It is because of the settings that I have made for demo purpose. I wanted to show a quicker signal generation, that's why you are seeing so many signals. But you can optimize it as per your requirement. So what happens in this strategy is, whenever RSI goes above 70, LE happens in a call, and let me show you how this works. So I'm zooming into this. So here you can see RSI cross 70. RSI cross 70, it is because of the input parameters that I've given. So RSI crossed 70 and I got a buy signal here. एंड व्हाट डज द बाय सिग्नल से, टाइप एली सिंबल दिस एंड इट इज सीई. सो आई व्हेन आरएसआई क्रॉसेस 70, आई एंटर इन अ लॉन्ग पोजिशन एंड कॉल. And if I already have a long position in put, it automatically exits my position in that put. For example, here you can see type LX Nifty PE. So simultaneously, my long entry is created in a call, and my short exit is being. My short exit is done in the put that in which I already had a position. So this is how the strategy works. Now for this strategy, what you have to do is for a setting that you have to come back to the manual, and you can see all the instructions are given here. All the instructions are given here, which you have to put. And let me show you. So to manage the settings, you have to go here, click on settings. Now here again, I have changed the RSL N to 4 for quicker signal generation, and it is my 1 minute chart. And the we just got a signal. I will show you the signal that we got. So we already had a long position in. So we already had a long position in call. So right now, when RSI just crossed 30, and what we got? We got a LE input and LX in call. So we exited the call. Now coming back to the setting. So you have to define your intraday trade session, end session, and choose the base symbol. Then you have to enter the expiry here. And you can also put the targets. Specify everything as per your requirement and click on OK. Now after this, let's come back to the manual. Now then you have to do the API bridge settings. Now how will the how does the strategy chooses expiry? So the strategy chooses expiry on the basis of the nearest one given, the nearest expiry that is given. So for that you have to put, you can see here, and if we go back to the cloud, here also I have selected 11,800 CE, 11,800 PE, 11,900 PE and CE. So similarly, in whichever strike prices you want to trade in, you want to create, you want to get your position created in. In option, you have to add all those expiries in the market watch here, in the symbol settings in API bridge, and then whenever a signal will be received, the order will be placed in the nearest expiry. Either it will be LE or LE input or LX in call. So whichever signal it will receive, the order will be placed in the nearest expiry. You can read about it in detail here. And to set automation, again, you have to copy this code and you have to go here and add alert on RSI options. And you have to add the alert from here. I already have created the alert. So that is why how we are receiving signals, and I just showed you how the signals are being received. So if you want to read more about this strategy, you can go to this help manual and you will find it here in the FAQs here in the help manual. Now this is always NSE options algo strategy for trading you. I had already set it up in the cloud so that I can simultaneously put two strategies and I can show you how this works, the whole setup works. Now let's come to order management settings for different strategies. So what are the order management? So if you remember, when we were talking about trading view strategies, we had defined these strategy in these strategy types. We had categorized these strategies in these strategy types. So now, for example, here, Super Trend by Kivank Ozibilchik. Here, this is a trend without predefined price. So what order type you should be preferring for such a strategy? Since Kivank Ozibilchik is trend without predefined price, which falls into this category. So I have created this table on various strategy types and the various order types are given here. And what problems or what limitations or benefit that they give are also mentioned here. So for example, the super trend strategy was trend without predefined price. So if we use that strategy and we put limit order, so as per this, we can miss the opportunity if the limit order does not get filled. Now, since it is in trend, the market is not in momentum, so there are less chances that our order might not get filled. And then if you are trading in market, your opportunity will not be missed because trade will happen in as per the market price. Then SLL, so even if the price gets triggered and your order does not get filled, again, here are less chances for that because market is in trend. So your order might not get filled if the price doesn't touch the price that you have given. But there are less chances for that. And in SLM order, you will not miss the opportunity because when the price will hit the trigger price, the trade will happen. The trade will be executed at the at the best available market price at that moment. Then bracket order, it offers you same features as per market that you will not miss the opportunity, and you have an additional benefit of stop loss and target. Now similarly, if there are strategies with the momentum with predefined price, so here again we have mentioned problems associated with it. For example, we can miss opportunity if limit order does not get filled and we do not have control to trade around predefined price. And if we are if we take the market order, so opportunity will never be missed, and again we won't be able to decide the price we want to buy it at because we are choosing the market order. Now SLL, the benefit it offers is you can trigger order at predefined price, and the problem is that you may miss the opportunity if it does not get filled. And then SLM, the SLM offers you benefits in momentum. You can prefer this SLM because first of all, for entry order, you can prefer SLL because even if you, there are chances of missing the opportunity, but there will be less slippage here. So, not the slippage part, but if the order does not get filled, then let's compare it with SLM. So in SLM, what happens is the trigger price will be touched and your order will be sent at the closest and the best available market price. So here you don't have the liberty to choose your price, but here you can choose the price. And even if it gets missed, then it will be because the price did not your price did not come. So you बट स्टिल हेयर यू कैन चूज द प्राइस यू वॉन्ट टू ट्रेड इन. नाउ इन ब्रैकेट ऑर्डर इट ऑफर द सेम बेनिफिट्स लाइक स्टॉप लॉस एंड टारगेट with the additional benefit of stop loss and target as and the same features of as present in the market order type. Now similarly for other order types, these all the order types are defined, the benefits and the problems that are associated with them. For example, if there is a mean reversion with predefined price. So here, if you are going for a limit order, you can miss the opportunity if limit does not get filled. And in market, you do not have control to trade around predefined price. And in SLL, the benefit is that you can trade you can trigger order at the predefined price. And the problem is that you may miss the opportunity if the order does not get filled. And in SLM, you will never miss the opportunity. And in bracket order, again, same features as market with additional benefit of stop loss and target. Now, this is how you can choose your order type after categorizing the strategy, after categorizing your strategy among these strategy types. You can see the problems and the benefits associated with a particular order type, and on that basis you can select the best suitable order type for your strategy, because it order management is an important component of system trading. Now let's take a quick recap of how you can set up algo trading. So first, what you have to do is you have to sign up for ChartBridge from aliceblueonline.com. So from here, you can sign up for API ChartBridge from here. And after that, you have to sign up if you are new on TradingView. Then you have to sign up on TradingView. If you are new to this, if you already have it, you don't have to sign up. You just have to get started with the strategy. And the next step is apply your favorite strategy from MyCoder or use TradingView public library. Either you can use TradingView public library here, or if you want to set automation based on Pine script, you can refer to these already written codes, already written strategies, already written Pine scripts from here, from the MyCoder help manual, and you are good to go. You can start with algo trading. This is very simple process. Just sign up with the ChartBridge, sign up with TradingView, and follow the instructions given in these documents, and you can get started with algo trading. I hope this webinar was informative, and now if you have any questions. If you have any questions, you can ask them in the chat box. So the recording of this webinar will be available, and you will be notified whenever it will be. So this was the first part of the fourth webinar of this series. Earlier we covered what and why of algo trading, then free tools, then tool comparison. Now we are discovering great strategies for Indian markets to start with algo trading, and this was just with the TradingView so far. In the coming, since this is part one of this particular webinar. So in the next webinar, we'll be covering MetaTrader 4 strategies, and we'll be covering aspects of backtesting. If you want to get started with algo trading, just sign up with the Chartbit, sign up on TradingView, and find this manual here. Just go to the panel, click on TradingView connection, click on FAQs on TradingView algo trading, and you'll find some already written Pinescript codes here. And you can deploy these strategies as per the instructions given in these manual, and you're good to go for algo trading. If you want to get started with algo trading, yeah, this is a procedure you can follow. It will be very easy to start with it because you can try it out. You can start with this in paper trading mode as well. So today I used live setup, but you can also set this up in paper trading mode. Just sign up for the paper trading mode and use free version of TradingView. So there won't be any cost for learning. And you can use these strategies and see how the algo trading works and learn how these work. Thank you so much for joining. We'll meet in the next webinar and we'll discuss MT4 strategies, MetaTrader 4 strategies, and we'll be talking about backtesting. Thank you.